Porsche Taycan Turbo S vs. Tesla Model S performance. Electric flattery. After 8 uncontested years, Tesla's Model S finally has a rival in the 2020 Porsche Taycan. We didn't set out to dangle the competition under Tesla's nose. The plan was merely to line up a Tesla Model S against a Porsche Taycan, the Tesla's first true challenger, to see if there's a new EV frontrunner. But if you want to experience the most powerful supercharger in the greater Los Angeles area, you're going to find yourself at SpaceX's Hawthorne headquarters, which is also home to Tesla's design studio. As we set up the Model S for a max charging session, Tesla employees mobbed the Taycan, sizing it up on a granular level. They were visibly impressed by the build quality on the pre-production Porsche and genuinely excited about a new EV contender. Their level of open-mindedness, far exceeding what we've come to expect from Tesla owners and fanatics, is no doubt one of Tesla's strengths. In years past, electric vehicles were great at delivering gas-free driving and zero emissions, but they lacked performance and driving range. Today, many EVs have a driving range of 200 miles or more, and with models like the Tesla Model S and Porsche Taycan offering outstanding performance, the EV is just about ready for the mainstream. Below we put the Porsche Taycan versus Tesla Model S so you can make an educated decision between these two performance-focused EVs. Tesla Model S versus Porsche Taycan. The Tesla Model S brings its design simplicity to the interior with its digital gauge cluster and do-it-all 17-inch touchscreen infotainment system that also doubles controls for other systems. However, unlike the Taycan, the Model S has no Apple CarPlay or Android Auto compatibility. Inside, the Porsche Taycan is a model of the future for automotive interiors. It features the luxury buyers expect from Porsche combined with so much tech. This abundance of technology starts with its generous use of screens in place of physical buttons and gauges. This Porsche electric car includes a 16.8-inch curved digital instrument cluster with an external screen for lighting and chassis function. It also features a touchscreen infotainment system with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, a passenger side display, and a display for controlling the heating and air conditioning system. The Model S boasts a clean-looking cabin with hidden air vents, a sleek dash, and a yoke-style steering wheel. In terms of interior utility, these electric sedans are as follows. Porsche Taycan, passenger capacity, 4. Standard cargo room, 15.8 cubic feet. Maximum cargo room, 42.8 cubic feet. Tesla Model S, passenger capacity, 5. Front legroom, 42.4 in, rear legroom, 35.5 in, front shoulder room, 58.4 in, rear shoulder room, 55.1 in, standard cargo room, 25 cubic feet, maximum cargo room, 61.4 cubic feet. Powertrain. The Porsche Taycan comes in four models, each with its own level of performance, starting with the 402 horsepower base Taycan that zips to 60 miles per hour in 5.1 seconds. From there, the lineup goes to the 522 horsepower Taycan 4S, which features all-wheel drive and hits 60 miles per hour in just 3.8 seconds. Next is the Taycan GTS with 590 horsepower and odd combining for a 3.5 second sprint to 60 miles per hour. The Taycan Turbo is the next model up, with 670 horsepower and a 3 second 0 to 60 time. Finally, the range-topping Porsche Taycan Turbo S delivers 750 horsepower and a 2.6 second 0 to 60 time. The Tesla Model S comes in two flavors in its base setup. The Model S comes with two electric motors, odd, and a 670 horsepower powertrain that sprints it to 60 miles per hour in just 3.1 seconds. The Tesla Model S Plaid has 120 horsepower and tri-motor odd, which sprints it to 60 miles per hour in just 1.99 seconds. This makes it the quickest production car in the world, driving range and charging. While performance is great in both of these models, many buyers seek an electric vehicle for its all-electric range. The Porsche Taycan's base model with the standard performance battery pack can travel 200 miles on a charge. Upgrade to the Performance Plus battery, and the air jumps to 225 miles. Moving into the odd, Taycan 4S drops the base air with the performance battery pack to 199 miles. But the Performance Plus battery bumps this back up to 227 miles. The Taycan Turbo can travel 212 miles on a charge. Upgrading to the range-topping Taycan Turbo S drops the air to just 201 miles. The Taycan's charging time varies by your power source or charging station and is as follows. 120-volt household outlet, over 86 hours. 240-volt 30-amp outlet, 14 hours. 24 minutes, 240 volt 50 amp outlet. 10 hours, 30 minutes, 50 kW DC fast charger. 1 hour, 33 minutes, 150 kW DC fast charger. 36 minutes, 350 kW DC fast charger. 23 minutes, according to the EPA. A new Porsche Taycan will cost you an average of $800 to $950 per year to charge. Tesla has long been the king of air. And it continues its dominance in the face of the Taycan with its base model delivering 405 miles of range. Moving into the Plaid model trims this range to 396 miles. If you opt for the 21-inch wheels on the plain model, the air drops to just 348 miles. Tesla lists its charging specs differently, measuring them by miles of range per hour charged. The Tesla Model S charging rates are as follows: 120 volt household outlet, 2-3 miles per hour. 240 volt power outlet, 30 miles per hour. Tesla wall connector, 44 miles per hour. Tesla supercharger, 200 miles in 15 minutes. The EPA says, on average, a new Tesla Model S will cost $550 to $650 per year to charge. MSRP. These EVs are far from economy cars, as the Porsche Taycan starts from $82,700 and rises to $185,000 in the Turbo S trim. Fortunately, the Taycan still qualifies for the federal tax credit of up to $7,500 and other state and local EV incentives. The Model S is equally pricey, ranging from $94,990 to $129,990. Also, the Model S is no longer eligible for the federal tax credit, though it may qualify for state and local incentives. Which electric sedan is better for me? The Porsche Taycan and Tesla Model S are great vehicles, but they cater to slightly different audiences. The Taycan is for buyers who want the prestige of driving a Porsche and the sporty look that comes with it, despite falling behind in straight-line performance. The Taycan is also for those who want a futuristic look and feel, with its forward-looking design, copious screens, and standard Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. The Tesla Model S is best suited for a family that still wants incredible straight-line performance. It boasts a roomy cabin with a large cargo area for hauling luggage and other items. How to save money on a Taycan or Model S? The Porsche Taycan has a few promotional lease offers, starting at $1,049 per month for 36 months after paying $11,549 at signing. There's also a 36-month lease on the Taycan 4S that runs $1,499 per month with $14,389 due at signing. The Model S 36-month lease runs $1,239 per month with $7,500 due at signing on the base model and $1,749 per month with $7,500 due at signing on the Plaid trim. You can also search for used versions of each model and save a few thousand dollars. The issue is that buying a used Taycan means you won't qualify for the federal tax credit, so account that into your potential savings versus new. As for a used Model S, you'll find lower prices and trim levels in previous model years, which could save you thousands. Electric cars can feel weird to drive the first time you try them, and it does take some getting used to when you set off in silence. That's especially true when dealing with a high-performance car. After all, there's no rumble from the engine vibrating through the chassis and no roar when you depress the pedal. Getting in the Porsche Taycan still feels like you are getting in a sports car. The low seat positioning, the luxury interior, and the multitude of tuning options, from the electric suspension to the sports mode, the car feels wide and planted to the ground, ready to deal with any corner you throw at it. The beauty of an electric motor is instant power, and the Taycan really pins you to the seat when you put your foot down. Even without engaging that launch control, it's stupidly quick off the mark, and just as quick when you need to pass other vehicles or join a motorway. Handling is expectedly impressive, and the car feels both solid through the bends and domineering on the straights. What's nice is that Porsche hasn't tried to fake engine noise on the Taycan. Instead, it has embraced a new electric sound, a word that has been amplified to give a futuristic feel. This electric sport sound is a £355 divided by $500 divided by $1,050 option, but it makes you feel like you're driving a spaceship. There's no one pedal driving option on the Taycan, so you still need to hit that brake pedal, and there's something refreshingly sporty about it. On a cold start, it requires a bit of a stamp to get it to react, but once the discs have warmed up, they perform impeccably. It's something you expect from sports cars and has a bit of a novelty here. The Taycan is Porsche's first fully electric car, first released in 2019. It now comes in two main body types and 10 variations, from the base sedan up to the Turbo S Cross Turismo. I tested the Taycan 4S, the four-wheel drive sedan model, which offers the longest range of the pack and arguably the best value for money. The 2022 Taycan 4S model has an estimated range of 227 miles and delivers 390 kW or 522 HP. This allows a 0-60 of just 3.8 seconds using launch control. The Turbo S model delivers 750 HP divided by 560 kW and a 0-60 of 2.6 seconds, but a range of just 201 miles. While not as long-wieldy as the Panamera, the Taycan is still much larger than the iconic 911. It's very much a four-door, everyday vehicle rather than a weekend plaything. And yet, this car feels much close to that original Porsche DNA than any of the more recent additions. Despite being fully electric, the Taycan feels like a Porsche in that you're still driving a serious sports car rather than a computer on wheels. Hero Wars. I spent 4 days driving the Porsche Taycan 4S on a recent England and got to experience how it performed on highways, country lanes, and around cities. It's not perfect, but this is, without doubt, the most fun I've had in an electric car to date. Recommended videos for you. Porsche could have very easily just created a fully electric version of the Panamera. After all, the car was already available in hybrid forms. However, in creating a brand new model, it was able to optimize the design for the electric motor rather than fit it around an existing design. The Taycan is a more attractive car than the Panamera, feeling more like an elongated 911. While many F fans are eagerly awaiting a true two-door electric sports car, this four-door offering is at least a step closer to that. Perhaps a 911 EV is still too much for Porsche fans. The Taycan 4S follows the original sedan design rather than the wagon back of the Cross Turismo and Sport Turismo. To be, the sedan feels sportier and more traditionally Porsche than the Turismos, but both have their appeal. Aside from the good looks, the Taycan has some impressive design features. Air curtains above the front wheels help reduce turbulence, while the three-stage rear spoiler controls the air at the back. A fixed glass panoramic roof is available as an option on the sedan models, providing a bright, airy feel to the interior. And the door handles extend out when the car is unlocked and recess back into the body when locked. As standard, the Taycan 4S sits on 19-inch aero wheels, but the model I tested had the 20-inch sport versions, which show a hint of those giant brake calipers. You can go up to 21-inch wheels, but remember that this will affect the range. Inside, the Taycan doesn't look significantly different to other Porsche models. However, many of the manual switches are displayed on recessed digital panels. Behind the steering wheel sits a 16.8-inch curved display for the instrument panel, complete with touch control for lighting and chassis controls. A central 10.9-inch display provides infotainment options and main vehicle controls. The center console houses a third 8.4-inch portrait screen that provides quick function access to everything from temperature settings to charging functions and phone controls. This can also act as a touchpad for controlling items on the main screen, saving you from reaching up while driving. There's also a head-up display option available. You sit low in the Taycan, as you would expect for a sports car, but once in, you have great visibility for all angles. The model I tested featured the Sports Chrono package, which includes a multi-function GT steering wheel with a top center marking, mode switch, and textured material grip that warms when the heated seats are activated. A nice touch for a cold morning. The Chrono package also includes a digital and analog clock on the dash, with a single hand that ticks round in seconds for lap times. I understand that this is a nod to 911 history, but, to me, it feels a little out of place here. The back seating gives a generous amount of room for passengers, and there's plenty of storage space. It features a large trunk with an option to fold down the rear seats for even more room. There's also a front trunk which is big enough for an overnight bag or a few bags of groceries. There's no shortage of technology inside the Taycan 4S. It's just not as in-your-face as in other EVs. The entertainment system supports both Android Auto and Apple CarPlay with wireless connectivity and native Spotify integration through your Porsche 499. In the US, you can also get Apple Music integration without a smartphone being attached. Unfortunately, I found the CarPlay integration wasn't always perfect. I had to stop the radio before Apple Music from my phone would play. However, the model I tested didn't have the latest PCM update, which includes new colored icons among other updates, so this may no longer be an issue. The dual screen setup works nicely, and I found the touchpad area really handy for making changes on the move. The vehicle controls are really easy to access, and the adaptive air suspension with its lift mode was handy when encountering particularly evil-looking speed bumps. The Porsche Voice Pilot allows you to easily control functions such as heating or navigation using a simple Hey Porsche command. The inbuilt navigation system benefits from the Porsche Intelligent Range Manager to take your current charge, vehicle settings, and speed into consideration when planning a route. It even ensures the battery is at an optimum temperature when you have a route planned to a charging station. There are a number of autonomous driving systems on board, including adaptive cruise control and active lane keep, which adjust the steering to keep you in the lane. This certainly helps on long journeys, but is by no means a hands-free experience. The surround view 3D uses cameras on all sides of the vehicle to form a bird's-eye view of the car, which is very handy if parking. You can also use active parking support to allow the car to park by itself, or even remotely via the app without you needing to be inside the vehicle. The Taycan's one Achilles heel comes in the form if it's rammed.